Different companies and holdings play quite an important role in the social and economic development of any country. Preparing for transactions, getting to know business partners, stock exchange analysis, journalism, these are only a small number of areas which require legal person analysis. Lampyre system lets you easily process huge volumes of legal person data, quick access to any legal person's info, statistical information in an easy to study and analyze way, all internal connections of a subject company and its founders, and management on a clearly readable graph visualizing data on a map. All this is in favor of tremendously decreasing the volume of the analyst's time and work. Analysts may use the data they already have, or they may download it from different sources. For example, we have created a request to download data from the better.companieshouse.gov.uk resource on legal persons. Let's assume that we have to find how a certain company and a person are connected. You can see how it can be done with the help of Lampyre in this video. In order to start working, you have to create an investigation or to open the previously created one. You can do this with the help of hotkeys Ctrl plus Shift plus N or through the file main menu. All the tools for creating a new or opening an existing investigation are there in the context menu. Let's suppose we're interested in data on McLaren Technology Group Limited. Each object on the resource mentioned has a company number assigned and it goes into the input parameters for our request. In order to make a request for downloading data, let's add this company to a new schema and input its number. For this, we select New Schema in the file main menu. In the Pictures window, we look for the company icon. We drag it to our schema, we double-click it to open the graph element editor, we add the company number 0196-7715. We close the window and now we can proceed to making requests. For this, we right-click the company icon and request to search for information on the company and then for the info on private individuals connected to it. You can see the status of your requests in the requests window. As soon as your request is done, the results are automatically uploaded to your schema. We can view all the data on this company and private individuals connected with it in the content window. We can also view this in a table. For this, double-click the request in the requests window. If needed, you can export your request results into a file of preferred format. To do this, click Table and choose a format to export into. Now let's get data on legal persons which are connected with the already found private individuals. This will be level 2 search depth. We select all private individuals in the content window and make a request to find all connected companies. Again, we can follow the request status changes in the requests window. As soon as your request is done, the results are automatically uploaded to your schema. We can change the graph layout for a better perception by clicking the hierarchical layout button in the Express panel. We get the data in a structural way. Also, by double-clicking the request, we get data for the newly downloaded results on the companies of the second level. Now, let's find out how a particular company and a private individual are connected. This may not be a direct link, but, as it often is, through someone or something else. Finding this connection without any tools is real difficult most of the times, but you need to perform such tasks quite often. Here you can see how to solve such problems quickly with the help of Lampyre tools. Let's select two vertices between which we need to find a connection. Okay, let it be some Dr. Mayer Klaus and McLaren Racing Limited for a company. We need to find the shortest link between the vertices of the company and a person in a company types with certain IDs. Finding these two vertices on the schema. To do this, let's use the cross-module feature and intersect the data on the schema with the data in our table. To make it comfortable, let's place the table under the schema. We choose our table in the tabs here and drag it down. Pop-up menu appears, which lets you choose where to place your tab. We choose placing it under the schema. Now, when we select something in our table, we see that the same is selected in our schema too. So we select the needed vertex and enlarge its icon to make it more noticeable. We need to pull any corner of the icon to do this. Now we do the same for the second vertex, a person in a company. Hold Ctrl on your keyboards and select both vertices. Right-click any of the selected vertices to open the context menu. In the drop-down list, select to search for the shortest path. We can transfer it to a new schema and change the layout for a better perception. To do this, we press Ctrl plus N. So, in our new tab, change the layout into the tree-like upon the selected items. Now we see the connection between our specified vertices along with all available statistical information in the content window to the right. The task is completed. Also, if you need to analyze data on a holding, you can use a GIS map. For example, it will be easy to build a map of all the company's offices if you have addresses or coordinates in the results of your search requests. Select a request in the Requests window and click the GIS map button. By default, icons of the specified objects are visualized on a map. Let's switch into heat map. To do this, we need to open the Explorer window and view the options of visualization on map. We tick heat map and untick GIS objects. What we get is a heat map of the holding's offices by their number. When working with map, you can use the cross-module feature and intersect the same data visualized in different ways. For example, at the same time, you can use a table and a GIS map. The content window data also changes and rearranges depending on the values selected. The same way, we can find a connection between any other objects and then visualize the results on the map for a more comfortable analysis.